Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here, and because Easter holiday is just behind the corner, it's nearly knocking on our doors. I was thinking to do some Easter tags, and it wasn't my idea. I mean, to do tags which can be hung somewhere. It was like in communication between me and Jackie Holiday. She asked me if I have some idea for tags which can be hung on the trees on some passageway in the park, which I think it's a beautiful idea to put there some tags. So I have created this one where you have a tag which you can pull out and put back. It's not too hard to do it, really. It's a kind of easy tag. What you will need, it's if you have oval die to cut the shape of egg, that will be amazing. I don't have oval die, so I made for myself this. I print out my eggs and I found few beautiful images, Easter images on internet, mostly on Graphic Fairy website, which is totally amazing website for any kind of, you know, clip art. So I think it's, or vectors images. So I do have those two sheets. They will be like free downloads. Link will be down below in the description box. If you don't have oval die, you can print out this one and you can start to play with me. To craft with me, not play with me. Come on, Evie. So, I do have here those tags. They are 3 1/4 by 1 5/8 mini tags, which I used in that egg. I did print out those eggs and this I glued on a very, very orange paper, this paper. And then I cut out with a teeny, small frame around. And then I do have like clear cuts. One it's embossed, this one, and other one I'm leaving plain. And then I'm gonna use that tack and some ribbon. And because it's Easter, I think it is very bright color of green green will be just amazing for that. This tag, it's totally amazing because I can take off this reinforcer sometimes, not on every single one, but mostly it's not too hard to take it off. That previous one went pretty much really well. This doesn't look that way. This is kind of glued properly. Yikes. Okay, yeah, good. So what I did, it was, I took that ribbon and I placed that ribbon through to my tack. Come on, Evie. And that tack is in the size which can be put inside of this egg. It can fit inside. That's why I am using those small tacks. So I put that ribbon there. I put a little bit of glue here in the middle. And place there that ribbon. And here from this side, I just fold it back and put their glue as well. Fold it back, and then on the top I glued back that reinforcer. It doesn't have any, you know, any purpose on there for me now. It's just like decoration, and I'm gonna secure with this that ribbon, so hopefully it will hold properly. I'm gonna let it dry. I've got here those small prints from those sheets, and I think I'm gonna use this beautiful teeny chicken in the basket. And I made those images small enough to fit to those eggs. And then I found out that they are exactly for these small tags, which I'm very grateful for that. See? Glued yourself. So I'm gonna put that image on the top to secure a little bit more the ribbon. Here it will be a little bit over that reinforcer, but because mostly it will be inside of that egg, I'm not worried too much about it. And then what I did, I just placed that egg somehow in the middle. Those prints, if you will use it, you will notice that one side it's very clear and that other side has like a shadow here. So this is the bottom of that egg. This is the top of that egg and this is the bottom of that egg. Oh, sorry. Sorry, my camera just start to zoom. So this is the bottom and I hope here, yeah, bottom of that egg. I'm gonna place that tag, I think, here. So I'm gonna place it, that tag, just with teeny, meeny, small part to stay in that egg. And I will try to make a position where here it's a top, kind of in the middle. So here I need to glue that ribbon. You can use the hot glue gun. I'm gonna use this Uhu glue. And I will hope for the best. So here I'm gonna glue that ribbon. With that Uhu glue, with the hot glue, it will be much more faster, that's true. Now I'm going to fold the ribbon over that tag and I will try to make a position of the tag, I think this way. Like this, fold it over as much as I can. Now I'm going to put a glue here on the top to make sure that the top will be glued properly here on those sides. And I need to make sure that I'm not touching that tack, that it's still there, some kind of gap between tack and between my glue. And now I'm going to glue that other half. Stay there, stay this way and this way. And try, do not move the tag inside, otherwise you will glue it all together. And now I just need to wait to make sure it's all dry properly. And I think where I did cut out wrong way, because it's normal, when I'm using my scissors, it doesn't work the way I want. So I'm gonna just clear those all over edges, hopefully. That's very weird that I can't, you know, cut properly with my scissors. Like this, yeah, no. Okay, it looks better. You can use distress inks if you want and distress all those edges. And I think I'm gonna let it dry. And I've got here from my previous work, I'm always saving those, you know, offcuts. And this has beautiful paper. It's, I'm not sure which journal I made, but I like this side. So for the other side, I have used Shabby Shooters distress ink. I think I'm gonna start again and just dab to those off cuts. Like this. I'm gonna fold it half. I guess it doesn't have to be, you know, exactly, because we're gonna cut teeny weeny small strips, like really teeny weeny small, and they don't have to be straight, they don't have to, you know, to be perfect, because we are now creating grass, and grass is better when it's not perfect. When I did cut few of these teeny mini strips, I sprayed that a little bit with a water, and then I start to, you know, create the grass like this. Okay, like this. You can let it dry. Where it's my heating gun? I can't see my heating gun. Where I place it? I did tidy up again. You know, I think I'm gonna finish with that trying to clean my to clean my craft room. It's always disaster for me. Then I can't find anything. Oh, here, there you are. There you are. Ah, found it. Found it. I'm gonna use heating tool to dry it a little bit. Like this. And then I just took the egg. Here, I think I need to cut a little bit more. I don't like that white edge. Okay. I'm gonna put glue here on the bottom. And I'm using this Uhu glue because it needs few seconds to dry properly. I'm not gonna use anything what dries really fast, because here I wanna, you know, to place the grass. Oh, come on, stick in there. Oh, oops, this will be teen, really small. And with that green top, I'm gonna place it this way. No matter how long they are or short they are, how skinny they are, I just started to plant the grass like this. And I think I didn't make too many. I'm really bad gardener, I guess. I don't have too much of that grass. So this way. I'm gonna make a garden-ish. Garden grass. That way, and come on, Evie. That way. No, proper grass, it's never straight, like, you know, exactly same. Like this. Okay. And then I just choose some image. I think I'm gonna take another rabbit. And I'm gonna place this beautiful, sweet rabbit here. I'm gonna use a little bit of distress ink to make it look, you know, a little bit vintage. I'm in that vintage style. So I'm gonna place him here, I guess. can just glue on the bottom here and glue to his ears and fold it a little bit, make a bolt. Do not flat it down, but a little bit fold it this way. Like this. Yes. And here on the bottom I can put some flowers. Maybe I can cut some flowers from all these leftovers. Or I can use my trim. I got here this beautiful, very bright trim. I didn't use it too much yet. I think I use it only once in some journal. It wasn't really so many times when I did use it. So maybe now it's a time. So here I just cut that ribbon to the size I need to make there, you know, that hook, not hook, loop. To hang it on the tree. And I'm gonna take this beautiful trim. I'm gonna put a glue all around of this egg. And I will put that trim around. And I do have one more, but I didn't try it yet. I've got here a cup from Milk, this one. And I was thinking to change it somehow for Easter. To make it like a basket, maybe. Easter basket. I'm gonna put this trim kind of halfway out, halfway over the edge. So I can see the part of these beautiful flowers on the, from that other side as well. Like this. Those flower trims are wonderful to work with because they fold the way you need them. Like this. This I can leave empty, maybe for a writing note. I can put one more flower on the top or put their bow here. I think I will make a bow later. And from this side, I used my paper punch. This one, it is Artemio flower punch, this one. So I used this paper punch to create few flowers with this paper punch. I don't have any other butterflies to use it here, which will be beautiful to have butterflies somewhere here. I don't have any other. I will have to have a look to my paper punches if I do have somewhere. I think I do have somewhere. Butterfly paper punch. And I'm just gonna put their flowers here and there. Maybe one more flower here on the bottom. Somewhere here. And here will be beautiful if there will be butterfly. Or maybe you have some stamp where it's saying Happy Easter. So make some note. And it's he. It's teeny, meeny, small. Egg duck with duck. Like this. And here I can put maybe some another sticker. Yeah. Because inside is that duck. So here, I'm gonna glue this like this. And I do have the Easter tag done, which has also message spot. So you can write message here. You know, maybe I will find that butterfly and I will place some butterfly here. It will be really gorgeous with some butterfly. Where is that other one? I think I had there. So I've got two tags. And I'm gonna try to do something with this pop lid. I do have in my head to make like a gasket, but to be honest, because I didn't try it yet, I'm not sure if I will be successful. Therefore, book pages are most wonderful thing I can use if I'm not sure. No, from this one, this way, I'm gonna draw how big it's this bottle cap. And I'm gonna cut around as much as I can. I think this is about half an inch around. If you have circle die, you can use circle die if you will try to alter some bottle cap. I do have double-sided tape from the other side because it's, you know, plastic. And I'm gonna let it sit somewhere in the middle. Here I'm gonna cut strips around. And just fold it over the edge. Like this. And fold. And fold. Fold. And to make it flat without some, you know, ugly edges, it's good to go one by one. Do not rush to glue, I don't know, 2-3 all together straight away, but really one by one they will like lay down one on each other this way. Like this, to lay it down here, and the last one. I'm gonna press it properly to that lid, and I will try to just fold it here. If there is enough of the double-sided tape, it's probably not. Like this. It's not too nice, but I will cover that with grass. Okay. You know, I remember when I've been small, we did paper craft like this. Some super simple something. What was funny to do. And I did enjoy it. I did all those beautiful things at school, like kids. And I know I spent hours with scissors and glue, and I did those 3D projects, and I was so happy when I was successful. And then I wasn't happy because I had to tidy up my room. So I was like, oh, I don't want. And it was big mess all the time, like now. It's all the time same. I'm gonna try to press this inside. Well, I don't have cover this strip. Maybe I can cut to be like proper cover.
They can cut strips because it has that double-sided tape. Maybe it will get glued. I don't know. Yeah. And press it inside. And I think here I will have to cut that extra piece with my scissors. And because it does have the double-sided tape, I do have everything on my scissors. That's no good. This is really like a playing. This is not what should be like professional craft. This is where you relax, guys, okay? Do not judge me. This is for relaxing. Take your kids, take your grandkids, grab some bottle caps and come to relax with me. Okay, I'm gonna leave it like it is. Even those edges are not straight and they are not decorative, but I do have that bottom and it's covered all over. Now I do have here also some decorative papers, and I think I'm gonna use some. I saw something with butterflies. Here. See, here I do have butterflies. I should cut out one of these on that egg, maybe later. So I'm gonna take a guillotine and I will put, I think, half inch strip and another half inch strip, and I will place them, and one more. Okay, one more half inch strip. Like this. I will take a glue. I think for myself I will have to fold it in the middle to know where is the middle of those strips. So I'm gonna fold them. And now, oh, oi! What the hell is wrong with my glue? What's wrong with my glue? Oh, wrong side. That was wrong side. Okay. I think there is something wrong with my glue. When it's dry, I can make a hole here in the middle right now to make sure that I can. It's not dried properly. Hopefully, it will not destroy my machine. I'm gonna put there that 1/8 of inch, and I will try to make a hole in the middle. Hopefully, I am. It looks like I am nearly in the middle. Okay, not exactly. That was so close. And if you do like vintage style, I guess the best way is distress it now, because then when it's 3D, it will be impossible. So do your distressing now if you want so. Here I'm gonna use just this one.
pardon me. I'm gonna use distress ink also on these edges, and because this bottle cap was with pattern, with this pattern, it makes that bottom looks like a really basket. Now I'm going to try. Oh, I should make a fold, exactly same fold. I totally forgot that I want to make a fold. So I'm gonna use my scoring tool. So it will be not so easy craft. I'm gonna use my scoring tool to make sure that those folds will be exactly, at least those folds should be at the same position. So I think 3/8 will be just enough. Three eighths, and I think I'm done with all of them. Oh, there you are. Now I need to put glue on those folds, and those folds glued to the bottom of that circle, of that lid. Okay, so I'm gonna start with this. Pardon me, and I'm gonna glue that opposite. Kinda ish. And then I'm gonna try to glue this one here and the opposite one. Kinda ish. Here. And then I will glue this one. And opposite one. Oh, I did too many. It's like it's already I did too many. It's already looks totally different than like gasket, I know. There are sometimes just two. Okay, am I? It's glued already. So I guess just two of them will be enough. Should I try to take it off? Yes, I should. Which one's last one? This one. No, I shouldn't. It's glued already. Okay, just two strips will be good enough to create, you know, decorative edges. The decorative that hunger. That will be good enough. I'm gonna continue. Once I start it, I will do something with this. I'm gonna take my paper punch and cut a circle to place it on the bottom of this creation. Yeah. And I just lost my... I'm gonna glue this on the bottom. I should try that before I wanted to share it with you. Yeah. Yeah, only two strips will be good. And I'm gonna do again the grass. Teeny, meeny, small strips. Like this. And I'm gonna spray it with water. And smoosh it, smoosh it, smoosh it. I definitely need just two hunks in there. How I will put it inside now. And a little bit more green. To make sure it's green. Okay. Like this. And I will try. Yeah, it needs only two. Really, I promise. I'm gonna just cut one here. Or even only one. And one here. So this is no good. This wasn't good at all. I'm gonna make a bowl. Using these. I guess. Oh, I can make bowl. Okay, just like this, or white one. Here and here. Okay. I'm gonna use it like a bowl. But this way. Because I don't like it. You know, that white one. I'm gonna keep that green one. Put a glue here. And fold it. And put a glue on that other side. And fold it again. Try to keep it equal, those sides. If that will be only possible. Yeah, it's not what I wanted. Okay, I'm gonna put there that grass. I guess do not do this one. And inside will be space for some another rabbit. This is too big one. Hey. Okay, inside will be space for teeny meeny small chocolate. Which I don't have. And here I will probably, because I already cover that that hole I made where I thought I'm gonna hang something. So here I will probably make just another bowl. I had to stop that camera. My son just came from work, so we had a chat, and I just made small beading. Here. And I decided that I will go through. At least I will try to go through. I'm losing grass. So I will try to punch it. Oh! Again, if you do something like this, please be careful. Do not hold the paper where your needle will go. Do not punch your fingers. And I'm gonna try to hang that butterfly in there, like this. I'm gonna put that grass back. Maybe it will be good to glue that grass on the bottom. A little bit, not too much. And do I have something more? Maybe orange butterfly. Where is it, you know? Spring. Okay. And I'm gonna give it a try and make a knot as close to that butterfly as possible. I'm far from it, like far from it. Here, I'm gonna cut those ends and try to take them inside. So I do have hanging for this one as well. And inside can be small chocolate or it can be small eggs. You know how to do small eggs? To use that aluminium foil, like alobal, it's called in my language, aluminium foil, and mold it in the eggs. But this way you have small basket and you can put there anything you want. I guess I'm gonna use also here. I've got beautiful bows. I'm gonna hang it in our windows or in the trees probably. So I'm gonna put one bow here. Like this, and another from opposite side, I guess. Like this. And let it dry, so I will have there also teeny meeny small bows. Under, oh, it's not dry yet. Here it's better to use hot glue gun to make it fast and dry fast. Because this Uhu glue, it's, you know, it's moving. But this way, you can have with a butterfly inside. Is it there? Yes, it is. Small butterfly inside. And my grass is falling down. So this is my sharing for today. You know what? I kind of like it. It looks so cool. I really kind of like it. I can imagine inside those small eggs made from that aluminium foil. Or if you do have, you know, some mold, to make a mold in there. And those two teeny mini tacks with tuck inside. So this is my sharing for today. I hope you will get your kits and you will craft with them to make them busy. Thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful day. A link for those free downloads will be down below. Have a wonderful day. Take care about yourself and see you next time. Bye.